so happy we alive.
This is Patrick Moore, and welcome to Louisville Late Night. Today, we're really happy to have a guest of great distinction and Kentucky heritage with us, Gatewood Galbraith. Gatewood probably has had an effect on the culture of Kentucky quite different than what he has even thought of. Although he has a quite a interesting and broad perspective. But I can remember a number of years ago when I was living in Lexington, Kentucky as a student at U of K. I opened a newspaper and there was a letter to the editor of the Lexington Herald, and this person was writing in that they felt like that marijuana was the laws against marijuana use was draconian and totally out of line. And anyway, the effect that this had on me reading this, and it said that it was an attorney or a law student named Gatewood Galbraith. And anyway, the effect of reading that letter was, it was not only both prophetic and amusing, but it was also a huge increase in some kind of confidence in the legal and political profession, if you will, the whole thing of government. And, you know, hearing someone identified as an attorney speaking the truth just was flabbergasting.
The Supreme Court okayed the 1937 Marijuana Tax Act. Excuse me, was marijuana a big problem back in 1937? No, it wasn't. The reason that they passed it was because it was the first time that the government ever took the power to tell the people what seeds they could plant in the ground and what they couldn't plant in the ground. By virtue of that law, the government severed their citizens' relationship with the natural cycle. They were able to come in by virtue of saying, you can't plant that one seed in there because it represents such a vilified plant. They took it upon themselves to be able to tell you any seed that you could plant. So when the people ask Galbraith, why is the change in the marijuana laws, why is it important to the people and to this country? Because it returns to the people the right to plant a seed in God's earth and consume the green natural plant that comes up out of it.
Now this is the Million Marijuana March, and today there are demonstrations just like this in every major city across the world.
Are you with a party?
No, sir, I'm independent. I've run twice for the Democratic nomination in 91 and 95 and got beaten in the primary both times.
I think that the laws against marijuana are the most vivid illustration of where this government has overstepped its bounds in policing private behavior. The petrochemical, pharmaceutical, military-industrial complex has utilized the lawmaking powers of Congress to get through legislation which has criminalized the farmer who's gone into competition with these synthetic manufacturers. Hemp is the number one fiber, the number one fuel, the number one food, and number one medicine. So the laws against marijuana are the most important step that this government's special interest have put together and put on the people to remove them from the natural cycle of things. Unless people actually get out in the streets and actually demonstrate and actually push the envelope, this First Amendment has no life. I've been at these things when we had 50 people. I've been at them when we had 20,000. And I'm always empowered by seeing one person stand up and try to give life and vibrancy and existence to the Bill of Rights in this society.
Yes.
can leave this demonstration and go get in your car and get out on the road. And they can set up a random roadblock in front of you and make you get out of your car, bring up a dog to sniff you, your car, and all its belongings, take blood out of your arm, make you pee in a bottle, if they think you got something. That is a police state. Do you think John Wayne would have put up with that? I think John Wayne would have said, I'm afraid not, Pilgrim. I'm afraid not, Pilgrim. This is where I draw my line in the sand. And this is where I draw my line in the sand. I will not live in a police state. Our fathers and our grandfathers did not fight and die on the beaches of Normandy and Iwo Jima so that you would have to pee in a cup to hold a job in America.
We don't run. We don't compromise. We don't quit. We never do. We look for love. We find it in the eyes. The eyes of me and the eyes of you. You are the road. You are the only way. I'll follow you forevermore. We'll look for love. We'll find it in the eyes that see through all the doors. And we don't run, and we don't compromise. We don't quit, we never do. We look for love, find it in the eyes of me, the eyes of you.
In his own right, Gatewood has been a leader, an active politician. He has run for governor of Kentucky 3 times.
That doesn't stand for W, by the way.
And happy to have him here today. What's going on right now with you?
Patrick, I appreciate the invitation to appear on the show, and I'd like to say hi to all the viewers here. As to what's going on right now, I've just come down and met two very interesting people who seem to have an opportunity and present me with an opportunity to talk about on some of my favorite subjects as citizen Galbraith, not candidate Galbraith. That's a very important distinction. For those of you who may or may not know, I've lost 2 very important elections in the last 13 months, and that always takes kind of a toll on me, so I've been kind of sitting back and recuperating and getting over the bruises. What's happened is we've conducted 2 really phenomenal campaigns in the last 13 months.